broadest of the sciences, some sense the reductionist queen of the sciences, and certainly the most mature of all the sciences. And we have learned an enormous amount. Whenever I feel depressed about the lack of news from the LHC or whatever, I look back 50 years ago or 100 years ago and feel just exhilarated by the realization of how much we've learned, even in the last 50 years. In the traditional fields of physics, we have discovered and understood the basic building blocks of matter and the fundamental forces that act on it. In the older science, that of astronomy, astrophysics, we have mapped out the entire physical universe to a large extent and reconstructed most of its history. And in the framework of ordinary matter, the kind that we're made out of, we see around us, we have achieved exquisite understanding and control of matter in all of its phases, down to the nanometer scale atoms. But I'm not going to dwell on the successes and the triumphs and the understanding. I'm instead going to talk about the most important product of knowledge, which is ignorance. And of course, I don't mean ignorant ignorance that leads to bigotry, racism, and other bad things, but rather the informed ignorance that's produced by advances in knowledge. The new questions that we are able to ask once we have a grasp of knowledge in a certain area. So I will try to address some of the new questions that we are asking now that we could not have asked 50 years ago, since we weren't informed enough to be able to ask them. Perhaps we asked some of these questions, but not in a way that was addressable by the scientific method, that was addressable by observation, by experiment, and by theoretical modeling. The frontiers of physics really lie in the borderline of knowledge and ignorance, a theme I'll come back to at the end. And there are many, many frontiers of physics. One of them, in fact, is now the physics of living matter, which was the title of the Solvay conference that just concluded, where physicists are attempting to apply some of their methods tuned over the last 400 years to the incredibly complex and difficult subject of living matter. But that was a part of that. Those frontiers were discussed in the last lecture and will be largely the subject panel discussion. So I'll concentrate on some of the more traditional frontiers of physics. Frontiers of cosmology at the scale of the universe as a whole, 13 billion light years or 10 to the 26 meters. I'll discuss the frontiers that arise in the contemplation, the observation of black holes, which permeate the universe, and pose interesting questions for astrophysics as well as fundamental physics. They're about the size of the Earth and of the 4 meters. And then I'll turn to the frontiers of quantum matter, ordinary matter that's around us, which is the scale of nanometers, the scale of tens or hundreds of atoms, as well as the physics of quarks and gluons, the physics of nuclear matter and subnuclear matter at 10 to the 18 meters. And finally, I'll turn to speculations that we are engaged in understanding string theory, quantum gravity, and space-time at a scale of 10 to the minus 35 meters. What is kind of astonishing is that we are often contemplating ideas in physics that transcend 61 orders of magnitude, from the universe as a whole down to what is perhaps the smallest possible distance.